quickly approaching. First-time runners of the pig might be wondering, what exactly should I wear? Well, this morning, News 5's Valerie Abati has the answer for you.
The Flying Pig Marathon is just days away, and what experts are telling me is if you don't have your wardrobe yet, time is running out.
When planning for a marathon, the last thing you might think about is making a fashion statement. But if you don't plan ahead, experts say you might be sorry. Bob Runker, owner of Runker's Running Spot, says start with the shoes, and by now, you should already have those in hand.
A big thing would be to not try something new on the day of the race.
Don't forget about what's in the shoes, too.
Socks, that's the forgotten thing by a lot of people.
Bob suggests no tube socks. And for socks and clothing, the enemy, cotton.
Because cotton just holds on to water and it creates an environment just ripe for blistering.
Try instead a synthetic material like Coolmax or Dryfit. Even wool is an acceptable material.
And you said wool. Isn't that going to make them hot?
Surprisingly, it doesn't.
This leads to the thing most people do wrong, overdress. If you have something that you can pitch, wear that until your body warms. And don't forget the body glide.
The principle, though, is to reduce friction. So those areas, maybe under arms or other areas where we think that we might chafe, it's good. It's very good to lather up.
If you listen to Bob now, your body will thank you later.
The main thing is just to have fun. So if you want to wear the pig outfit or the tutu, go for it. Just be prepared for some chafing. Valerie Abati, News 5.
Now, don't forget, News 5 is your official Flying Pig station. We're going to have all the coverage you need on Sunday, May 6th, which is race day.